According to 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 17 to 18, "You therefore, beloved, knowing this beforehand, be on your guard so that you are not carried away by the error of unscrupulous people and lose your own firm commitment, but grow in the grace and the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. To Him be the glory, both now and to the day of eternity. Amen." We praise the name of the Lord because we are taught, we are growing, we are learning in the ways of our God so that we will not lose our own firm commitment. So we are here for the sole purpose of committing again to the ways of our God. Let us pray. We thank you, Father, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, that we are about to partake your truth and your light in our lives so that we will be accurate and aligned to your purposes, plans, and your perfect will for every one of us, and most especially for your kingdom advancement. Grant us the grace, O God, to hear your Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus, this we all pray. Amen and amen. So, isang magandang hapon po sa bawat isa at mga kasama natin sa SCB. I thank Pastor Wilbert for the privilege. And let's continue part 2 for maturity guided righteousness. First off, we discussed the definitions of term regarding maturity guided righteousness. So, yung guidance, being guided, we all need guidance because we all have the tendency of being selfish, of being focused on our own motives. So, according to James 3:16, when we are selfish, when we are focused on ourselves, it is evil. It is bound to worldliness and sin and destruction. So, we all need guidance. And what kind of guidance we all need? We all need that kind of righteousness. So, what is righteousness? Most of us think yung righteousness are only in the four corners of the ministry. Praying, worshiping, fellowshipping, and everything else. However, God's righteousness is not only something that can be found inside, okay, in the four corners of the ministry. We may be called religious, as it is called monastic living. But many Christians, kahit seryoso sa monastic living, are failure living in the life of Christ. So, hindi pa rin makita ng mga tao sa paligid o masasabi na ang isang Kristiyano ay tunay na kasama nga niya ang Diyos. Not living the life of victory in Christ. So, otherwise, they are living in the life of compromise. So, what is this life of compromise? It will be difficult for people to determine that we are kingdomly people. Many will find it hard to distinguish that we are righteous in the sight of God. So, what is righteousness? It is the complete opposite of lawlessness or sin. Pag walang sinusunod na batas, lawlessness. Okay, walang sinusunod na authority sa buhay, nagiging lawless. Or the Bible says, lawlessness is sin. Okay, madalas makita kasi natin ang lawless, ang pagiging sinful ay only for blatant sin. Mahalang ang kaluluwa, mga hayagang kasalanan, but no. It's also in the form of lawlessness. Walang sinusunod na batas o authority sa kanyang buhay. So the complete opposite of righteousness is lawlessness. Kaya sabi ng Panginoon, kahit churchy, kahit monastic living, full of prayer, full of worshiping, full of fellowshipping, complete attendance in the church, not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, will enter. According to Matthew chapter 7, kahit nagpalayas ng demonyo, gumawa ng himala, at nagsalita sa iba't ibang wika. Meaning to say, nasa loob naman ng ministry, nasa loob ng church, claiming Christian, but God claimed those kinds to be lawless. They will not enter. God was not pleased. So the kind of righteousness na hinahanap ng ating Panginoon sa ating buhay is the kind of righteousness that is mature, not masyado kasing broad yung term na righteousness. So kaya ang topic po natin is patungkol sa maturity-guided righteousness. Simply because masyadong broad yung righteousness. But I am trying to correlate that righteousness through the truths of the Word of God in the Bible, that righteousness is equals to maturity. So, binasa natin nung nakaraan bilang review, Matthew 7:21-23, even for churchgoers, yet they were not found by God to be pleasing. And from Matthew chapter 3, verse 13 to 17, God acclaimed Jesus to be pleasing. So, we reviewed definition that we need guidance and righteousness. And what that kind of righteousness we need? Righteousness is also a form of being pleasing to God. Being pleasing to God. Just like Jesus, God acclaimed Jesus to be pleasing for himself. Kailan? When did God acclaim Jesus to be pleasing for himself? When Jesus fulfilled all righteousness according to Matthew chapter 3, verse 13 to 17. After Jesus said to John the Baptist to fulfill, let it this be, to fulfill all righteousness. So see, being pleasing to God is also equivalent to being righteous in the sight of God. So righteousness can be so generic and broad in terms for us to understand, but to translate it to our lives, righteousness is being pleasing to God. And what kind of being? Kailan na declare again after Jesus fulfilled all righteousness? And at the same time, when Jesus, okay, was acclaimed by God to be his son. Okay, this is my son in whom I am well pleased. So, ito po yun, yung ating pinag-aralan nung nakaraan. Being pleasing to God, okay? According to Matthew chapter 3, verse 13 to 17, when the Father recognized that He fulfilled all righteousness, Jesus fulfilled all righteousness. Second, when the Father declared His sonship. So what the sonship means for righteousness is being matured. So being righteous and being mature is at the same important matter for God for us to be pleasing. So, kagaya nung sabi natin nung nakaraan, being pleasing to God is living in the life of righteousness and maturity. Therefore, righteousness is equals to maturity. Righteousness is equals to maturity. Righteousness being so generic and broad again. No? So to translate us to be easily understood and be manifested, no, masunod natin sa ating buhay is that yung righteousness na hinahanap pala sa atin ng Diyos is also yung maturity. Okay? Yung maturity. So, pinag-aralan natin din nung nakaraan yung tong maturity na to, again, this is a call for every Christian to be mature. Have this attitude. This is how to eagerly wait and expect Jesus to mold and transform our body, this lowly body condition, toward what? His glorious body, subject all things to himself. So the grace to govern and the power to prevail in all circumstances, even while we are on earth. Di ba? Pag tayo mature, mas madali nating masisiyasat yung mga bagay-bagay na tama compared sa mali. At the same time, we are able, okay, to have that grace to govern and the power to prevail whatever circumstances we have. Why? Because we are mature to understand and we are mature to respond. Okay? So, according to Philippians 3:12 to 21, maturity, now that not that I have already grasped it all or have already become perfect, but I press on if I may also take hold of that for which I was even taken hold of by Christ Jesus. Brothers and sisters, I do not regard myself as having taken hold of it yet, but one thing I do, forgetting what lies behind and reaching forward to what lies ahead, I press on toward the goal for the maturity of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus. Therefore, all who are mature, let's have this attitude. And if in anything you have different attitude, God will reveal that to you as well. However, let's keep living that same standard to which we have attained. Yung maturity po, hinahanap sa atin ng Diyos. Kagaya ni Pablo, kagaya ko, not that I'm saying I have it all grasped or have been perfected in maturity, but I press on toward that goal. Okay? Just like Jesus. Therefore, we all need to mature. This is the kind of righteousness, kind in the stature of Christ God is expecting for us. So, being guided in maturity. Okay? So that we will be considered righteous, pleasing to God. This is all we need, my brothers and sisters. And, okay, sabi dito, sa Hebrews chapter 6, verse 1 to 6, therefore let us leave the elementary teachings about Christ and go on to maturity. Okay, not laying again the foundation of repentance from dead works and of faith in God, instruction about baptism, and talon tayo sa 6, and then have fallen away to be restored to repentance because they themselves are crucifying the Son of God all over again and subjecting Him to open shame. In short, okay, lumagot na daw tayo, iwan na natin yung mga alam nating kamalian o ating mga kalikuan, being immature. So go on to maturity. This is a call for maturity. According to the title of this context. No? So everyone is called. Kasi kung paulit-ulit daw tayong nagkakamali, nagkukulang, nagiging liko, and as considerably immature sa ating mga gawa, bagamat tayo ay religious, okay, the Bible tells we are like of those na kasamang ipinapako muli si Kristo. Saan daw? Subjecting him to public shame. Okay? Kasamang ipinapako si Kristo at muling inihiya ang kanyang pangalan. That's why marami sa mga mananampalataya, no, na bagamat seryoso naman sa pananalangin, ngunit kung hindi makikita yung paglago, yung pagiging mature, okay, marami pa rin sa ating paligid, unang-unang ating pamilya, mga malapit sa atin, lalong-lalo na yung community. It's hard for them to recognize that we are called by God. God is with us. Therefore, we need maturity. Okay? We need maturity. And according to Ephesians chapter 4, this will continue until we all come to such unity in our faith and knowledge of God's Son that we will be mature in the Lord, measuring up to the full and complete standard of Christ. See, God is expecting us to that full stature of Christ. And as we go on this study, I realized, okay, ito palang ating pinag-aaralan as I listen and carefully study this maturity-guided righteousness. I realized this has something to do also with stature. So growing our stature is growing also our maturity-guided righteousness. So again, according to Pastor Wilbert, the stature is God's view. Okay? God's standpoint about us. Okay? A man with stature is a man respected in heaven. Just like Abraham in Genesis chapter 18. According to God, shall I hide myself? Shall I hide? Okay, what I'm about to do from Abraham? See, he considers Abraham. So we need to have that kind of growth. We need to have that kind of rising up in the spirit, rising up to our stature, or in a clearer way sa ating buhay is our maturity, guided righteousness. So pinag-aralan natin nakaraan yung Matthew chapter 24, yung patungkol sa servant that is considered God. The Bible considered the servant that is immature to prepare. What he needs is he considered evil. So most of us thought na yung evil, lawless, is something na kung saan outside church only. No. But even while we are churchgoer, again, the comparison is that God can also, okay, God can also disprove, okay, the Christianity of some. But if we are able to mature, okay, to have that kind of stature, okay, prepared for God. So laging kinukumpara ng Diyos yung kanyang pagpunta sa, ang kanyang pagparito at para pagdating ay kung saan dapat tayo prepared. And that is something matured people has. Okay? Yung being able to predict and prepare sa mga maaring mangyayari sa pagdating ng Panginoon. Okay? So maturity is proved by being ready and knowing and understanding of what will come next to our future. And to the true nature of maturity is being able to predict and prepare to what lies ahead. So we will not be caught off guard. Kung maraming pwedeng magsabi na, again, tayo Christian, tayo believers, but for the things and the purposes of God, we are not doing so. Okay? So, it's hard to find a fruitful life if we are immature. So, God considers evil slaves are those who do not make themselves ready and prepared for the coming of the Lord. And that is unexpected, as we all know. And if we desire to be deserving and a good servant, we must day in and day out be found out deserving, worthy, ready, and prepared for His coming and purpose all the time. Okay? So, kinakailangan ang bawat isa yung stature talaga mag-grow. It is required by God. It is required by God. So, ang hirap i-reconcile, kagaya nung sabi ko nung nakaraan, ang hirap i-reconcile, no? Na kung saan ang isang Kristiyano ay prayerful, full of fellowshipping, full of attendance, okay, sa church. Pero pagdating sa mga bagay, ay failure. Pagdating sa mga bagay ay, kumbaga, sablay. Okay, pagdating sa attitude, sa responsibility, sa fruit, okay, na hinahanap ng Diyos. Diba, lagi nating maobserbahan sa Bible, laging hinahanap yung pagiging fruitful. Laging hinahanap yung pagiging prepared. Laging hinahanap ng Diyos kung saan ready tayo sa pagharap sa Kanya. And many believers are telling na okay lang yan, mahal ako ng Diyos. Okay lang yan, pinapatawad ako ng Diyos. Yes, that is also valid point kapag ang konteksto ay tayo ay new Christians, new believers, and new followers of Christ. But for Christians na matagal na po sa Panginoon, okay? 10 years, 15 years, 20 years. It's difficult to reconcile the truth in us. God is the God of truth. Therefore, the truth shall set us free as well sa ating mga kalikuan, mga kahinaan. And we need that recognition, okay, from God Himself to fulfill that righteousness and to be called holy and pleasing to Him. So just like Jesus again, there is no perfect example other than Jesus Christ. He fulfilled all righteousness and He was acclaimed to be pleasing to God. This is my son, as a notion of maturity. So, pinag-aralan natin yung Matthew chapter 24 nung nakaraan, the positional advantage of being mature. Let's further dissect, okay, the words of truth with regards to Matthew chapter 25 naman. Okay? To further validate the truth that maturity is equals to righteousness. Therefore, we all, okay, need to come to maturity. Matthew chapter 25 verse 1-13. Then the kingdom of heaven will be comparable to 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the groom. 5 of them were foolish and 5 were prudent. For when the foolish took their lamps, they did not take extra oil with them, but the prudent ones took oil in flask with their lamps. Verse 5, now while the groom was delaying, they all became drowsy and began to sleep. But at midnight, there finally was a shout, behold, the groom, come out to meet him. Then all those virgins got up and trimmed their lamps. But the foolish virgins said to the prudent ones, give us some of your oil because our lamps are going out. Verse 9, however, the prudent ones answered, no, there most certainly would not be enough for us and you too. Go instead to the merchants and buy some for yourselves. But while they were on their way to buy the oil, the groom came and those who were ready went in with him to the wedding feast and the door was shut. Yet later, the other virgins also came saying, Lord, Lord, open up for us. But he answered, truly, I say to you, I do not know you. Be on the alert then, because you do not know the day nor the hour. So the parable of the 10 virgins, with this story, the Bible made a similarity for the kingdom of God. Okay, with this parable. So the kingdom of heaven, again, it speaks of, okay, being pleasing, being welcome to the presence of God, being pleasing, being made right, okay, having the right standing with God. So it is comparable to 10 virgins, okay, and 10 virgins has two groups here. The foolish, 5 of them were foolish and 5 were prudent. So again, the coming of the kingdom, the presence of God, okay, us being welcome to the presence, being pleasing to God, has something to do with being prudent and being foolish. And the time coming that is again unexpected. So every time the Bible speaks of the coming of the kingdom, it is always unexpected. It is always something that that everyone ay hindi masasabi. Pero the kind of believers that God is looking for is those prudent ones and not the foolish ones. And comparison to our subject for today is the maturity-guided righteousness. Okay? Hindi mapapahintulutan ng Diyos of His coming towards our lives and tayo ay maging foolish. So nakita natin dito yung foolishness and being prudent is also similar to being mature and immature. Now, let's again talk about the positional advantage of being mature here. So, number one, being able to prepare to eliminate the unnecessary, slow or delay, and being able to get ready the required advance and accelerate. So, Matthew chapter 25, in the verses 2 to 4, 5 of them were foolish and 5 were prudent, the immature and the mature. For when the foolish took their lamps, they did not take extra oil with them, but the prudent ones took oil in flask with their lamps. So nakita natin, yung negative side is yung unnecessary or merong slowness or delay, which we all want to eliminate in any circumstance. So, from this, the foolish did not take extra oil for themselves. But the prudent ones, they took oil, extra flask, okay, aside from their lamps. So many times, ganito po ang mga maraming mga tao, okay? They do not think of the future. They do not think of what will happen next. Therefore, marami ang hindi naghahanda. Marami ang hindi nagpe-prepare ng extra. Let's see a real-time case scenario. Okay? Ganyan po yung maraming immature, di ba? Kaya marami sa mga kabataan nakakalimot. Okay, for example, kaya madalas pagsabihan ng mga matatanda yung ilaw, mga switch ng kuryente nakapatay, mga saksakan nakabunot, mga extension wire naka-off, lahat ng appliances. Especially, yung gasera, yung gasol, yung mga talagang matindi ang pinsala kapag naiwan, yung plantsahan, yan, yung mga tubig. Sino madalas makaiwan? Yung mga kabataan. Pero yung mga matatanda, never na never nilang makakalimutan yan hanggang sa paglock ng pintuan, pati susi. Bakit? They are expecting their house to be intact pagbalik. Okay? At sino madalas makalimot? Yung mga adolescent. Yung mga adolescent, mga teenager. Why? Because they are immature compared to their parents. Kasi ang iniisip nila, kung ano yung gusto nila, kung ano yung focus nila. But the mature ones, they think everything. Yung masasayang na bills at nawasa sa Meralco, lalong higit yung safety kung may babalikan pa sila. That's how the mature, they think. They prepare extra, lalo na pag-aalis. Okay, anong susunod na mangyayari? Ako kasi, ang mga anak ko ay mga preschool toddlers, no? So alam na alam ko yung mga kailanganin nila pag aalis. So same thing sa mga parents ng mga young adults natin, 'di ba? So alam na natin yung mangyayari kapag umakyat dahil kulang pa sila sa balanse, mahulog sila. And same thing sa ating spirituality. Marami sa mga tao makikita mo yung maturity pagdating sa pagiging seryoso sa ministry. Kaya mapapansin mo, sino yung mga madalas nasa church? Mga matatanda. Salamat sa Panginoon, we are in the generation na marami ng masisipag na young professional, na mga young adult, youth sa church. Pero nung unang panahon, hindi pa ganun kaklaro, okay, yung maturity in the spirit. Kaya sino lang makikita? Yung mga manang at manong nasa church. Mga puti na ambo. Why? Because they know na malapit na ang paghuhukom. So, in comparison to spirituality, mas makikita mo ang pagiging seryoso ng isang Christian. Yung iba kasi, iba yung purpose ng church. Iba yung purpose ng pag-attend. But to those who are mature, they know the value of the word. They know the value of connection. They know the value of spiritual accuracy, spiritually discerned. Na ito yung hinahanap ng Diyos. At kapag tayo ay ganito, okay, we know our priorities just like Jesus. And sabi niya sa John, Matthew chapter 6, aanin mo yung damit, yung pagkain. So do not worry about tomorrow. Seek first the kingdom of God. Alam mo yung kailangan mong unahin. Alam ng mga Kristiyano kung ano yung priority. Okay? So doon makikita yung maturity. Being able to prepare to eliminate the unnecessary. So naiwasan yung slow or delay. So kailangan mong may balikan ka, may maiiwan ka, being able to get ready the required. No? Kaya maraming mga tao, especially sa finances, walang naiipon, walang na young professional, if I may address, no? Kaya walang naiipon, walang naipupundar, simply because ang focus wala pa sa future. Kami, but thanks be to God, kami nakaready na yung insurance namin, nakaready na yung burial plans namin. Okay, as early as our 24, no? And we are already contributory to the church because we know the importance. So that is the positional advantage of being mature. Okay? Sino yung mga madalas na uubusan? Sino yung madalas na nangangailangan? Yung mga hindi alam yung priorities ng kanilang buhay. So, second positional advantage again, so being able to avoid the untoward, being able to meet the needs. So, this is the same thing I've discussed from the last time, but from the last Matthew chapter 24, this time Matthew chapter 25 tayo. Verse 6 to 8, but at midnight, there finally was a shout, behold, the groom, come out to meet him. Then all those virgins got up and trimmed their lamps, but the foolish virgins said to the prudent ones, give us some of your oil because our lamps are going out. So ito yung mga may iwasan kapag we are guided by maturity, okay, and righteousness. So yung untoward incidents, sentinel events na tinatawag, ito yung mga ayaw mong mangyari. Tignan mo ito, naubusan. At anong nangyari? Dahil sila yung naubusan, sila ngayon yung nangangailangan. Sila ngayon yung nangangailangan. But on the other hand, to those who are mature and prudent, they are prepared to the coming untoward event. Pag naubusan, merong extra. Pag nangailangan, merong extra. Kaya nga, maraming mga tagapagturo ang nagsasabi, kung nakakapagpayaman lang ang prayer, kung nakakapagpayaman ang membership sa church, ang attendance sa church, then sana marami ng mayaman. But kahit anong pagsasakripisyo natin, no, sa ministry, but without being mature enough to prepare in finances, okay, hindi papatay-patay dapat, kundi laging masipag, hindi mapili sa trabaho kung anong meron, kung ano pagsikapan, palaguin, pagyamanin. Tamang-tama nga yung pinag-aaralan natin ngayon na itinuturo ni Pastor Wilbert, di ba? Yung tungkol sa finances. Okay, yung tungkol sa finances, diyan kasi maraming sumasablay. Yung maturity sa finances, knowing how and understanding what to prioritize and having that ability, okay, to produce wealth, it's not something to be gained by prayer. Prayer is part, but not only prayer. Faith without action is dead, just like a body without spirit is dead. Kaya tayo, bukod sa ating panalangin, kinakailangan masipag din tayo, masikap tayo, matyaga tayo, mapagtiis tayo. Kaya nga laging sinasabi sa Bible, kung ano yung mabuti, kung ano yung kaibig-ibig, okay, magsumakit, kung kailangan kumaiksi ang kumot, matutong mamaluktot, magsumakit, magsumikap, magtyaga, magtiis, ayan po yung itinuturo sa Bible. Pero marami, Hindi iniisip yung priority. Pag nahirapan, absent. Pag nahirapan, magre-resign. Eh, wala pa nga kapalit yung trabaho. Young professional, ganyan po ang marami sa atin. There is no such thing as easy money. There is no such thing as easy job. Iba-iba lang po yung forma. Okay? Maraming agad-agad nagre-resign pag nahihirapan. Kaya hindi ma-promote-promote. Kaya pag nangailangan, kasi ang sahod is minimum wage. So minimum. Kapag naubos yung minimum, walang extra. Kaya dapat tiyaga tayo, magtiis tayo. Naniniwala ako doon sa katotohanan ng pangako ng Diyos. Kapag nagtatanim tayo ng marami, marami din tayong aanihin. So magtanim tayo ng pagsusumikap, pagsumakit, pagtiyaga, pagtitiis, lahat ng ito. Inuulit sa Bible. Kaya nga sabi sa Bible, those who remain until the end will be saved. Yung mga marunong magtiyaga, yung mga pansin natin, no, those who remain until the end will be saved. Yung prinsipyo sa Bible na kung sino yung mas makakatagal, the finish, the end is better than its beginning. So kahit malakas tayo, matyaga tayo, kahit anong haba natin manalangin, kahit anong lakas ng tinig natin sa pag-worship, kung kakapusin tayo sa dulo, halimbawa sa ating financial, okay? Pag wala na tayong pangtustos, pag wala na tayong maitulong o magawa na paraan para sa ating mga problema. Okay? Ano pa yung maisusustain natin sa ating mga pangangailangan? Okay? Being able to avoid the untoward, being able to meet the needs. Yan po yung mahalaga sa atin bilang mga Kristiyano na masustain natin. Di ba? Kaya pala sabi sa Bible, even the elect, okay, maraming tatalikod. Why? Hindi naman elect na yon. Ibig sabihin, mature na yon. But, okay, or somehow, sabihin natin, matagal na sa Panginoon. Talagang subok na ng panahon. Pero, hindi natin maikakaila na kapag dumating sa pagsubok, ito kadalasan ang nagiging dahilan sa pagtalikod. Ano-ano ba ang source ng pagsubok? Number one, financially. Kung hindi tayo prepared financially, kung hindi tayo secure, okay, emotionally, okay, diyan marami pong tumatagilid, sumasablay sa pananampalataya. Kaya even the elect ay babaliktad. Even the elect will abandon. The love of many will grow cold. Sa tingin mo ba dahil lang sa nakalimutan mag-church? Or no? Or ayaw na? No. Subok na ng panahon eh. But the thing is, pag dumaan sa matinding pagsubok, okay? Pag dumaan sa matinding pagsubok. And kaya kinakailangan sa atin, we always prepare ourselves. We are mature in deciding everything. Yung mga hindi kinakailangan, talagang ma-eliminate yung mga kinakailangan lang. Okay? Kaya we need to be prepared and maturity guided in righteousness so that we will remain standing right. Kaya naman din yung iba nandadaya, kaya din naman yung iba nagkukulang, halimbawa sa pagbibigay sa Panginoon o pag-attend sa church. Simply because hindi nakakatayo ng matuwid simply because may kulang, may kapos, may sablay, unang-una sa trabaho. Hindi maka-absent kasi kapos nga. Or, hindi mapagbigyan yung schedule na hinahanap natin para makapaglingkod sa church. Kaya nagiging conflict yung schedule. Okay? Nagiging conflict yung schedule. Kami ni Deborah, more than 10 years na pong nagwo-work or 15. Okay? Pero never naging hadlang sa amin yung trabaho. Why? Because we are mature enough to decide and have that responsibility from the past employment namin that we are able to secure a job post. That we are able to secure financial security that will sustain us kahit na pagsabayin namin. And not only that, having 4 children, okay, 3 na lang, namatay yung isa, and yet continuous support in the family, in the ministry, and in the community. So we avoid the untoward in being able to meet needs, kaya nakaka-sustain. No? So mahalaga po itong positional advantage of being mature. Of being mature, maturely guided in righteousness, we can stand right and pleasing to God. Third, ayan, positional advantage of being mature. Being not a victim, being a victor. So Matthew 25 verse 8 to 9, but the foolish virgin said to the prudent ones, give us some of your oil because our lamps are going out. 9, however, the prudent ones answered, no, there most certainly would not be enough for us and you too. Go instead to the merchants and buy some of yourselves. So we see here, imbes na, okay, nagawa natin yung dapat natin gawin, imbes na ma-unlock natin yung opportunity, mag-grab natin yung opportunity. Yung iba, they lose the opportunity. They lose the that privilege of having yung binibigay ng Diyos na pagkakataon. Simply because, wala eh. Nung time na pwede na, hindi na available. Yung time na may pagkakataon, okay, sarado na. So anong nangyayari? Nagiging kasama sa mga biktima, sa liability, instead na, okay, accountable partner. Okay, instead na kasama sa responsible, nagiging liability pa. Okay? Nagiging liability pa. Ganyan po nangyayari yung pagiging unrighteous, immature, or foolish pagdating sa mga decision making natin. So, one real case scenario again. So, yung iba, habang bata pa, okay, or hindi pa naman ganun ka layo yung edad, no? So, pagdating sa pagkain, no? Kasi huwag natin lagi sabihin yung mga mabisyo. Pagdating sa pagkain naman, no? Ang, okay, ang tawag doon sa English nung pagiging masiba, gluttony. Sabi sa Bible, it's also a sin, gluttony, greediness. So, may dessert na, may leche flan na, may ube pa, may ice cream pa, at nag-soft drinks pa. Tapos, ayaw nating pawisan ni konting inip. Tapos sasabihin natin, mataas ang blood sugar natin. At parang nahihilo ako, mataas yung blood pressure ko. Okay? And there will come a time, oras lang po ang hinihintay ng ganun, no? Until such time, maging stress tayo, bumaba yung immune system natin, yung well-being natin, then such time, dun umaatake yung sakit at karamdaman. So maraming ganyan, nagpapabaya, no? Sa sarili, walang control sa pagkain, walang ehersisyo, ni konting papawis, no? Gusto laging naka-aircon, gusto naka-aircon, naka-electric fan pa. Okay? So what's the tendency? Walang na-burn, even some of the carbohydrates. Pag hindi na-burn, it will turn into fat. So, ganyan, at dahil hindi rin financially prepared, okay? Yan, minsan ang masisisi pa natin, yung mga magulang natin, mga young professional, mga young adults, we need to be prepared kasi ang pinakamahalaga po, ang pinakaayaw nating mangyari, untoward event is that yung may ma-hospital. Okay? Kaya minsan, ang sisisihin, sino? Walang pera. Pampa-check up, walang pera, pampagamot. No? Pero maraming travel, maraming mga party celebration, nagpa-birthday, may isang cake, hindi pa nakontento, may dalawa pang cake. Iba-iba ang flavor para may ma-i-groupie at selfie. And later on, pag may nagkasakit, pag may nangailangan mo ospital, sisisiin ang ospital, sisisiin ang gobyerno. So, playing a victim. Habang immature, kaya ang mga bata, kahit anong pigil mo, pag may nakitang candy yan, kakain at kakain ng candy yan. So, we must be spiritually mature and discerning as well. Papasalamat nga ako na ituro isang beses ni Pastor Wilbert sa Baguio yung patungkol sa health. I am health conscious as well being in the healthcare ally. No, so, ito po yung isa sa mga positional advantage of being mature. We will not be a victim, but we will be a victor. Kaya pwede natin sabihin, Panginoon, ako'y nakakalundag, ako'y nakakapaglingkod ng malakas. Ng malakasan sa iyo, marami pang magagawa sa ministry. It's because, okay, we will not be a victim, but we are a victor. Okay, we know what we need to prepare in advance. We know what we need to also avoid, no, being prudent, being mature. So, kagaya nito, imbis na, ayan, meron pa kapag nawalan. So, we have the with that advantage. Diba? The power to prevail and the grace to govern in every circumstances. You are now a prevailer. Amen? We are now governing. Kaya naiwasan po yung pagiging victim, okay, sa mga sirkumstansya ng buhay, simply because you are mature enough to prepare for it. God has given us the grace. Okay? God has given us the grace. Fourth, living life in lacking and slavery. Or power. Or sa kabilang banda, yung power and authority. Dito pa rin sa Matthew 25 verses 8 to 10. But the foolish virgin said to the prudent one, Give us some of your oil because our lamps are going out. However, the prudent ones answered, no, there most certainly would not be enough for us and you too. Go instead to the merchants and buy some for yourselves. But while they were on their way to buy the oil, the groom came and those who were ready went in with him to the wedding feast and the door was shut. So nakita natin dito, no? Power and authority are for those prudent and mature since they are prepared, since they are that right attitude, standing, okay, of having that extra. Given the circumstances of lackness, they have extra. So instead that sila yung nanghihingi, sila ngayon yung pwedeng mag-provide. Pero dahil hindi nila pwedeng i-share, dahil sila din kukulangin kapag sinare nila. But at least they have that superiority in that circumstance, right? So they have that authority and that power to decide. Sila ngayon ang nag-utos, bakit hindi kayo bumili na lang? At ito naman sa kabilang banda, itong mga immature, itong mga foolish, okay? Ngayon sila ngayon yung nangangapa, sila ngayon nagkakandamayaw, saan kukuha? At anong nangyari? Sige, doon na lang kayo sa labas bumili. Amo, nakita mo yung extra expense, extra weight, extra baggage that it may take its toll for those foolish and immature. Ngayon, sila ngayon yung maghahanap, ngayong nangangailangan na, okay, at the same time, nautusan pa sila, the same time, ano, gagastos pa sila sa mga merchants para mabumili. Instead na kung galing sa bahay, mas tipid. Okay? Mas tipid. So, ganyan yung, kagaya nung example ko kanina, ang hirap po. Napakahirap po may ma-ospital. I address everyone to keep ourselves healthy. To keep our diet healthy and to keep our physical body strong. Okay, so that hindi po tayo yung nandoon sa pangangailangan. Hindi po tayo nandoon sa disadvantage position. Okay? But we have the control over the circumstance. We have the power and authority to say, ganito yung kailangan ko, ganito yung nangyari, then therefore, I just deal with it properly. Okay? So, hindi na kailangan mag-fasting 40 days and 40 nights. Hindi na kailangan maglupasay sa Panginoon. Okay? Dahil sa mga pagkakataong ganito, no, pag nagkakakunda, tawag doon, nagkukumahog na. Okay? Diyan talaga yung tendency, malaki yung tendency ng kasalanan. Kaya napakalaga po nitong maturity guided righteousness or stature natin in the spirit to walk pleasing to God in every aspect, not just in the church but in every aspect of our lives, sa ating time, sa ating treasure, sa ating talent. We should be a good steward. We should be a good steward. Next thing, loss and damage, possession and dominion. Fifth positional advantage of being mature, according to Matthew chapter 25, verses 10 to 13. But while they were on their way to buy the oil, the groom came, and those who were ready went in with him to the wedding feast, and the door was shut. Verse 11, yet later, the other virgins also came, saying, okay, later, Lord, Lord, open up for us. But he answered, truly I say to you, I do not know you. Be on the alert then, because you do not know the day nor the hour. So see, nakita natin yung loss and damage it may take for the foolish or immature. Okay, laging late because laging nangangailangan, laging late dahil laging kapos. So late payment sa mga important dues. Okay, late tithe and offering. Late sa pag-attend ng church or kahit saan man, laging busy maghanap. Kaya maraming nawawalang nasasayang na panahon at pagkakataon. Kaya hindi maiiwasan din, from time and time again, puro kapos, puro kulang wife, it will lead us to destruction. It will lead us to loss and damage. Ngunit ano naman yung positional advantage? Magkakaroon ka ng possession and dominion. Okay, nagkaroon ng pagkakataon makapasok doon sa an? Sa kasalan. Sa paghahari ng Diyos, sa presensya, nagkaroon ng pagkakataon to be pleasing to the groom. Okay? At ano pa nangyari dito? Nawalan ng pagkakataon, nasarhan. So we see the loss and damage it may take for those being immature, being unprepared. So this is the kind of righteousness God is looking for us, that maturity-guided righteousness or the stature in the spirit. So let me tell you one statement here. Life is not only all about money matters. It is growing our stature and maturity-guided righteousness that will grant us the grace to live the life of favor, blessings, and protection from God. Again, life is not only about money matters. It is growing our stature and maturity-guided righteousness that will grant us the grace to live the life of favor, blessings, and protection from God. Ang akala kasi ng tao, pera-pera lang ang buhay. Kapag may pera, yun lang ang kanilang pupuntahan, yun lang ang kanilang priority, yun lang din ang kanilang schedule at mga iniisip. Pag wala, hindi nila bibigyan ng pagkakataon. Ngunit, ang sinasabi sa atin, lagi, we need to grow in stature, we need to be pleasing to God in every aspect, that maturity-guided righteousness. No, not only in the form of four corners of the ministry. Again, no, kaya pala sabi ng 1 Samuel verse 15 to 22. Okay. Validation of truth for this statement is that obedience is better than sacrifice. 1 Samuel 15:22, obedience is better than sacrifice. Why? No matter how much we pray, okay? No matter how much we pray, how much we fellowship, worship, without maturity, without that stature of maturity in righteousness, just like Jesus, righteous. Okay, what is that righteousness? Yung mature sa every aspect ng buhay natin. What? How? In terms of relationship. Okay, we are building relationship to grow our stature. We are studying the Word of God, righteousness, truth, okay, and everything else, growing our wisdom, our understanding, our knowledge, so that we prepare, knowing how to produce wealth, to secure our wealth, okay, to be pleasing to God in our time, our talent, our effort that is convertible to cash, and everything convertible to blessing, okay, connection, relationship, being accurate sa lahat ng bagay, mapagkakatiwalaan, responsible, everything. This is how to grow in maturity, growing in stature. This is what will guide us to righteousness and being pleasing to God. Just like Jesus, He fulfilled all righteousness and He was acclaimed by God. This is my Son in whom I am well pleased. Sonship speaks of maturity. Therefore, yung righteousness is equals to maturity. This will, okay, ensure, this will establish us to the life of favor, blessings, and protection. We will be protected from what? From the untoward circumstances, no? Yung mga biglang pangangailangan, meron tayo. Yung mga biglang may problema, we are able to prevail on that circumstances. Hindi tayo yung naaalipin sa circumstances. We have that blessing needed in times of need because God taught us to what? To sow our seeds in the right soil in the kingdom of God. Okay? And we will continue on growing in wisdom, knowledge in of Christ, so that we will receive favor with men and favor with God. So, hindi lang po pera-pera ang pangangailangan, kundi it's also growing our stature. And also growing our maturity, guided righteousness. So, kaya po sabi dito sa 1 Corinthians 2:6, yet among the mature, we do impart wisdom. Okay? Although it is not wisdom of this age or the rulers of this age, who are doomed to pass away. So, kinakailangan talaga yung obedience makita sa atin sa lahat ng prinsipyo, sa lahat ng aspeto, okay, ng ating buhay. So, this wisdom na kinakailangan, being wise, okay, kaya wisdom, being wise in every decision, in every point of our life. So, we will have that tendency to stand right. Tama, meaning walang sablay, walang kalikuan, walang kakapusan sa harapan ng Diyos. That's why it's easy to live the life of favor, blessing, and protection. Okay? So, ito po yung kahalagahan, no? To translate yung righteousness, which is masyadong broad, into maturity pala. To stand right, pleasing, honorable to God. Okay? So that we will have that positional advantage to have that grace to govern and the power to prevail. Let us pray. We thank you, Father God, for that message of truth that you have given us today so that we will not remain foolish, so that we will not remain immature, but we will rise up to that stature of maturity in Christ Jesus. We will rise up to that maturity where we will be pleasing in every aspect. We will stand right before you, O God, so that we will have that respect in heaven, so that we will have that approval with God. Hallelujah. By faith, O God, we will become pleasing and approved by you. We come to the full measure of Christ. Hallelujah. Tapos na po ang panahon ng immaturities. Tapos na po yung panahon ng aming mga kalikuan. But this is now the time for us to arise and shine. in the full measure of Christ by the grace of the Holy Spirit, by the power of the Most High God. Hallelujah, your spirit, not by might nor by power, but by the Spirit of God. Kaya pala napakahalaga ng yung Spirito, ang kabanalan mo, your holiness, your righteousness, for us to be pleasing to you, so that we will also fulfill all righteousness, and so that we will be pleasing, we will be called sons in the kingdom. Hallelujah. And just like for the mature people, they are entitled for inheritance. Kagaya sa amin, para nang sa gayon, hindi kami magkulang, hindi kami umroblema, hindi kami kumahog sa oras ng pangailangan, but we will be mature enough to understand, to be prepared, and to foresee what lies ahead, so that yung wisdom na binigay mo sa amin, ito yung mag-generate sa amin, ito yung mag-ooperate sa amin for us to manifest, to live, hallelujah, with the grace to govern and the power to prevail every circumstances. Thank you, Father God, for your words of life that enlightened us, empowered us today. In the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ, this we all pray. Amen and amen. So, ang kapayapaan at pagpapala po ng Diyos ay sumaating na. God bless and thank you.